Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We are going to discuss how to convert alcohols into leaving groups. Specifically, we're going to convert alcohols into halides, and we're going to perform this substitution reaction with reagents like HBr and HCl. So, as we've mentioned in the past, it's important to be able to convert an alcohol into a leaving group. In this case, our leaving group is going to be a halide. So we're just going to convert OH into X, and we're going to use reagents like HX. There are two ways this can happen. It's a substitution reaction. So there's two ways it can happen. It can go through an SN1 or an SN2. For the SN2 pathway, we're going to take our alcohol. We're going to treat it with HX. We will protonate the alcohol. That'll make the alcohol into a leaving group. And under the SN2 process, the halide will come around, attack the carbon, kick out water as a leaving group, and we'll have our substitution. This key step was an SN2 reaction. So that occurs most often when you have a primary or a methyl alcohol. We also have the possibility of doing SN1 pathway. SN1 pathway starts out the same way. We use our strong acid to protonate our alcohol, make this into a leaving group. The water now can leave on its own. We break that carbon-oxygen bond. The electrons go to the oxygen. That forms water. We get a carbocation, and then our halide can turn around and attack the carbocation carbon. And so this is more of an SN1 pathway, and it's something we're certainly going to see in things like a tertiary alcohol. So we have now a table at the bottom. Let's fill in this table. We have different degrees of substitution for our alcohols. We could have methyl, primary, secondary, or tertiary, and we have different acids. And it turns out the pathways will vary depending on what acid you have. HCl, HBr, and HI. So let's look at the methyl examples. As it turns out, chloride is not a very good nucleophile. It's not an SN2 nucleophile at all. So we can't do this on a methyl. Br minus and I minus, however, are good nucleophiles. Not great, but good. So we can do this substitution, and it'll follow the SN2 pathway. How about a primary halide? Well, too bad. HCl, chloride, is not a good nucleophile. HBr and HI can still both do substitutions on primary alcohols, and it'll follow an SN2 pathway. Secondary halides. Well, turns out HCl still doesn't work. And I'm going to say that HBr and HI also do not work. Secondary halides, secondary alcohols, they're too hindered for our good, not great nucleophiles, bromide and iodide. And their secondary carbocations, you can make them, but they're just not that good. So this is not a reliable method to count on either SN1 or SN2 for a secondary alcohol. Once you get to a tertiary alcohol, all of these acids can cause the generation of carbocations. So all of these will happen, and the halide will attack the carbocation that you form, the same across the board. So this is the scope and the limitations of using HX, hydrochloric, hydrobromic, or hydroiodic acid in reactions with alcohols to form the corresponding halides.